Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I'm excited because Corona is becoming solar 2D. All right, so a couple of weeks ago, it may have even been a month or more ago, I did a video called The End of Corona SDK, and in it I talked about the Corona Labs announcement that they were going to be moving the Corona platform to open source because they just weren't able to make it work financially over time. And it's something I'd been dreading for years. You have so much code base in Corona. I spent a lot of time learning Lua just specifically for that platform. And I was kind of sad about it. I was really pretty bummed out about it. But I was looking at their site the other day. Last week, on the 22nd of April, they made a new announcement, which is about a rebrand. So as they're moving it over to open source, they're also giving it a complete new rebrand where Corona will be rebranded as Solar 2D, and they're doing all the other stuff, offline builds, they're updating the plugins, and they're raising funds for it. So just reading that gave me a new sense of hope. Like, maybe there's a future for the Corona platform after all. First of all, changing the name, great idea, right? That was it. The last video I did about Corona SDK has been demonetized because I think the YouTube algorithm thinks that I was trying to capitalize on the virus, right? And you just can't distance it from the virus. I think it's best just to rename it to Solar 2D. But what I'm hoping is that the open source community picks this up and it has a thriving future ahead. Like, there's certain things that I've been looking for, such as integration with Huawei in-app purchases, supporting new ad networks, all that kind of stuff. And I'm hoping that there'll be an influx of new developers going into it, because it seems like it had a lot of attention back in 2013, 2014. It sort of like dwindled off. There's not so many books, not so many tutorials, but I'm hoping this whole new Solar 2D thing really takes off. So I wanted to bring that up to you guys in case for those of you guys who are Corona developers or have done some Corona development in the past, you may have missed it, because I would have missed it if I wasn't looking for other things on their website. And I was like, oh, thank God, it gave me a new sense of hope. My question for you guys is, my question is mostly for you guys who are Corona developers or you've done Corona development in the past. Are you excited about this? Are you interested in continuing Lua development with Corona? Or are you just like, dude, I've already moved on to Unity, or I plan to move on to Unity 2D? Because this is something where I think, yeah, I might pick that up again. So anyway, let me know what you guys think. Anyway, that is it for today. I will talk to you again next time.